I don't know. You tell me what you do.
Well, that's the big question. And, you know, I guess we'll have to watch and see.
And real situation from the perspective of, that's a dilemma for people, you know? And I think what it ends up speaking to is what kind of evidence you have, you know? If it's something that's real and you honestly believe that, you know, the elderly are being repeatedly defrauded, I think a human obligation is to do something about that. But if it's, you know, little nuggets that don't really add up and you don't really know, then you probably should mind your own business, you know?
And to your point, I mean, just being a lawyer, I don't know if I used to practice law, that's neither here nor there, but my mind goes to like, you get to a point where like, if you have certain evidence, you're like, I could implicate myself by not doing anything with this. I now know too much and this is sitting in my backyard.
Right. No, nobody wants to be aiding and abetting, right?
Did you feel that, you know, like, well, I don't know if you're watching like Beverly Hills or, I mean, that's the whole thing with like Erica Jane and like Sutton, you know, went to a lawyer and as she's being chastised, she was chastised. I don't know if you're up on all that, like any thoughts on, you know,
I'm through the first reunion episode of Beverly Hills. I'm a couple episodes behind. You know, I think everybody has to do whatever they are comfortable with to protect themselves. And I think that that's fine. If that's what Sutton felt like she needed to do to feel comfortable moving forward, great. Who cares? What's the big deal? You know, so, it's for her own peace of mind to sleep at night. Great.
So did you go to a lawyer in Salt Lake, Meredith?
No, I did not go to a lawyer in Salt Lake.
What do you think of the whole Erica Jane thing as you've watched this season with the rest of us?
You know, it's a very different circumstance, particularly because it all boils down to whether Erica had knowledge or not. And I have no clue. I certainly think it is very possible she did not. I can understand that definitely being the case, but I don't live in her house. I don't know, you know. You know, if she did, that's horrible. But I think it's very possible she did not. I can't say she didn't because I don't know, but I can get my head around her not knowing anything. Absolutely. Like I could, you know, she married a man who was much older than her. He was immensely successful before they ever met. It could make sense to me that she was not counting any pennies. It sounds like he was kind of controlling too, you know, so she probably didn't have access to a lot of information. So it could easily make sense to me that she didn't have any knowledge.
When you watch this scene that you weren't there, you know, when this whole thing, I mean, we heard it around the world, like, were you as drawn into this particular scene as we were, you know, like as the viewer, because you weren't there, you were kind of watching it as a viewer.
Yeah, of course, because I was not there. And, you know, and I'm sort of like, wait, what, you know, and here's the thing too, is when things are going on and you are not there, you always hear everybody's side of the story of what unfolds. And it's always just a little bit different. You know, everybody sort of just tells their side. That's human nature. You know, that's what we do. And so you're sort of listening to things unfold. And so that's what's really fun about this, is you actually do get to see these moments that you've heard about. You've heard, you know, several people tell a slightly different version of the facts. Sometimes a wildly different version, but in this case, slightly. And you get to see it unfold and take your own point of view on it, you know?
What was it like? Because like, this is another situation like Erica's, that it was unfolding in real time as you were filming. Like, what was that like? I mean, again, second season, it's not necessarily what you expect.
No. It's very intense to have something like that because, you know, usually when these big life issues come up like this with people you know, you kind of have a minute to digest it and kind of process your feelings on it. And you're seeing that, you know what I'm saying? You guys are seeing that. And that's usually a very private moment. So, you know, I think everybody has to kind of go through their own process. And because we are all so different, we all do it differently.
What about for you? I mean, like Erica and Jen are both still on the show. Like if this just, it would never happen to you, I get it. But like, if this were something of this magnitude in your life, like, would you stay on the show?
You know, it's always easy to speak when you haven't stood in those shoes. And so my immediate answer would be no way, you know? But I don't know until I stand in those shoes. You know, I would just be very afraid of something being used against me. You know, it's so easy. I mean, look, when you're filmed 24/7 and suddenly something isn't adding up or whatever else, and it can be tied back to something that can really change your whole life, I'd be a little wary. I'd be very, very cautious. I cannot imagine that any lawyer would advise their client that's involved in any type of legal proceedings, for the most part, certainly not criminal, to go on television, on reality TV. I can't imagine that would be the advice of any lawyer, but you know,
that's
each his own.
What I would think too. What about,
but I do understand them wanting to tell their side of what happened. I mean, it does make sense to me. I get it. I just don't know if it's the best idea, but I get it. I definitely get it.
I agree with all of that. What about, I mean, people have said the same about Erica. Like, do you think being in the situation, like Jen understands the magnitude? Look, we don't know if she's innocent or guilty, innocent until proven guilty, but like of the magnitude of the charges, you know, like she too has a social media presence that seems, from where I'm sitting and other people, you know, rather carefree. Like, do you think she understands like the federal government is involved? Like, this is not a joke.
I mean, I don't know how she couldn't understand that. And, you know, Sharif is a lawyer. I mean, he practiced law prior to being a coach. So she has someone explaining this like in her home to her. I mean, it's not like she's just going to these lawyers that she doesn't trust or whatever. So I would imagine she has to know, you know, I can't imagine she doesn't.
Yeah, I don't know, her social media, I'm just always shocked about. That's just me.
Well, me too.
Have you thought of texting her and saying, Jen, get off social media?
No, and I don't think that would do any good. I think that Jen does what Jen wants to do, you know? And that's probably why, if her lawyers did tell her, I'm not saying they did, I have no idea what they told her, but if they told her not to go on the show, I think she decided she wanted to because she wanted to tell her story, I'm assuming. I don't really know. I'm not inside her brain, but that's what I would presume.
Well, you don't have to give us any spoilers as we watch on this season. As we head into the reunion, anything that you are most nervous about addressing, anything you're most excited to address and bring up, like?
You know, for the most part, what you guys have seen so far, there's not a lot that I'm gonna go, that I'm so busy to address at reunion. I think that most of the circumstances that you've already seen have closure in the season, if they haven't already had closure. So my issues are more about what's to come later in the season that I'll be addressing at reunion,
which we've seen a few trailers.
I think I have to watch it myself to really understand, because like I said, I don't know what happens when I'm not there until I watch it with you guys, you know?
Are Jen and Brooks in a good place? Like, regardless of like what's to happen coming, like just from what we've seen, you know, which seems to have been resolved up to that point.
Yeah, I mean, Jen and Brooks, it's not, you know, it's not like Brooks and Jen are like friends that go out and have cocktails on a right. regular basis or anything. They're in a neutral space. I think they're both totally at peace with the situation and moving forward in life, you know. I don't think they're going to go have martinis or anything like that. But, you know, I think it's fine. It's totally fine, I think, for both of them, you know.
What about
Brooks is fine. He's moving on in life and he's happy and healthy and, you know, doing great. And I would presume that Jen is moving on too, from everything I've seen.